I'd like to start us out with a spiritual mind treatment. So just take a breath. If you want to close your eyes, that's great. And let's just remind ourselves of why we're here today. We're here in recognition and celebration of the one truth. Now, this is a spiritual universe, that each one of us is an individualization of spirit. Each one of us is a center of good and a universe of good. And since this is true, being a center, being a spiritual being, myself, as we all are, understanding that we live and have our being in spirit, through spirit, with spirit, and that spirit lives through us, in us, as us, and with us, I make my claim. I set my thought into motion with my words by declaring that this morning is the beginning of something wonderful, a beautiful day, a beautiful celebration, an opportunity for friendship, fellowship, and inspiration. And I know that as we come together here in harmony, we set in motion a sense, a feeling, a wave of harmony that flows out from this very place, out to our friends, our family, our communities, out into the world, like a pebble of good dropped in to the still waters of life. This is the truth, and I know that it is already so. I give thanks and invite you to know it with me by joining me in saying, and so it is. Thank you.
Spoken singing praise every morning. Praise for this being fresh from the Word.
Another grandchild.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
His name is Avery.
Oh, nice.
There you go.
It's so nice to have you back with us, Rick.
It's nice to be
So I'm Reverend Kate, and I'm so happy to welcome everyone to the Center for Spiritual Living Carlsbad this morning, where we're always reminding ourselves that there is a power for good in the universe greater than we are, and we can use it. So first off, I would like to invite Jim to come up front.
Hey, Jim.
Jim who's doing everything. Thank you, Jim, for volunteering to come up front and light our candles this morning as we remind ourselves of the underlying spirit of life and the divine unity of all. So first we light a candle for life. Life is everywhere present, flowing through each and every one of us. There is only one life. That life is God's life. That life is our life now. So please affirm with me, I am life. We light a candle for love. The birth of love happens within each one of us every time we make room for the Christ consciousness in our hearts and recognize our unity. We are points of love within the heart of God. So please affirm with me, I am love. We light a candle for light. The light of God is the presence and the power. We are always walking in the light. We radiate the light of God wherever we are. Please affirm with me, I am light. We light a candle for beauty. We are made in the likeness and image of God. We are each whole, complete, and beautiful, just as we are. We accept the beauty of God's perfection as our perfection now. Please affirm with me, I am beauty. We light a candle for joy. Joy is the very nature of spirit and the true essence of each of us. We celebrate the joy of our own rebirth in the God consciousness. We each bring joy to the world. Please affirm with me, I am joy. We light a candle for peace. Today and every day, we open our hearts to peace. We are each a center of peace in our world. Please affirm with me, I am peace. Finally, I invite you to take a moment to recognize your own inner light that is always shining within. As we each honor our own metaphysical path of wholeness, oneness, and mental healing through the practice of universal spiritual principles. Thank you, Jim.
Yes, it is.
Thank you, Jim. So I have a few announcements to share today. First, we want to welcome visitors who are here for the first time and invite you to make yourself at home, stay for coffee and cookies, and sign our guest book. Then I want to remind everyone that every Sunday we offer spiritual mind treatment as our gift to you, either after the service, in person, during fellowship, or afterwards. You can ask me, Reverend Amandra, Dr. Maddie, or Larry, for a personal affirmative prayer. Or in the lobby in the corner, there's the box with a paper form that you can just fill out and put your request in. And then our prayer team will do treatment for you during the week. And I have to say, it's really nice when people give us feedback, you know, that things are going well. And we do get some really wonderful positive feedback. So I appreciate that too, if you have put in a treatment request and have experienced the demonstration that you wanted, let us know. So next week is Easter Sunday. Now, does anyone have an Easter hat? It's the day of the year. If you want to wear a hat, please. It's the perfect time. So we welcome hats. We'll have some eggs. And, you know, if you have a friend or family members that want to do something on Easter, it's the perfect day to bring them along. Then, oh, and Dr. Maddie's going to be speaking. So.
Yay.
Then in April, Reverend Maureen is going to be back. Maybe she'll be back for Easter. I'm not 100% promising. But in April, Reverend Maureen and I are going to offer a new Centers for Spiritual Living accredited class called Mental Equivalence. And it's really about how do you make that spiritual prototype of what you would like to experience in your life. So I think it will be good. It's actually only 5 sessions long. And I did put a sign-up sheet on the welcome table so that we can have enough materials for people. So if you would want to sign up, that'll be great. And we do, I think we have our updated phone list out there also. So if you want to pick up one of those. And this is important to me and to our organization. We have a form and it looks kind of long and like I don't really want to fill it out, but it would be really great. It's a membership update. And we haven't actually updated since before the pandemic. And I know a few people have moved. So if you could fill it out so that we have information about our members and friends before our annual meeting, which will be in May. So the other good thing is it does include an emergency contact space for you to put in case we ever wondered where you were and wanted to find you, could call someone. Anyway, this is a community-based spiritual center, you know, and we do like to be friends. We enjoy our fellowship, although things change every week. You know, we have a team of ministers and a team of volunteers. And so today, I want us to recognize our volunteers. So first, let's recognize Pat for the beautiful flowers. Which I guess came from your yard, and they're so perfect for all Sunday. So thank you. And our greeters, well, Jen and Jim and Ruthann and I all pitched in to do the greeting today. And for treats, I hope you enjoy the cookies I made.
Yay!
I'm not speaking today. I made cookies yesterday, so that was kind of a fun change. And I want to thank Jim for doing our recording. I also want to thank Jan for all that she does, and Angel, who isn't here right now, but he came in the early morning and set everything up for us. So, thank you, everyone. The volunteer sign-up sheet is right out on the welcome table, so everyone is welcome to sign up. Now, if you could look in your programs and find the group greeting. We'll read it together. God is all, both visible and invisible. One presence, one mind, one power is all. This one that is all is perfect love and perfect abundance. I am an individualized expression of God. I am ever one with this perfect life, perfect love, and perfect abundance. And now, shall we, anyone who wants to stand up, we're going to have a group of
stand. I'm saying this, but I like to see you stand.
Yeah.
You know this song? If you want anything, what you gotta do first is release. So it's called I Release. Oh, I release and I let go. I let the spirit run my life. And my heart is open wide. Oh, yes, I'm born here for God. For no more struggle, no more strife. With my faith, I see the light. I am free in the spirit. Yes, I'm born here for God. No more struggle, no more strife. With my faith, I see the light. I am free in the spirit. Yes, I'm born here for God. I am free in the spirit. Yes, I'm born here for God. One more. I am free in the spirit. Yes, I'm born here.
I had put all my sweaters and warm stuff away and had to dig them out. And the reading today is from Matthew 18, verse 3. As little children, we must become as little children. How we long to return for a return of that simple trust in life which children have. In their minds, there are no doubts. They have not yet been told that they were sinners or destitute of divine guidance and spiritual life. The life of the child is lived in natural goodness. God is natural goodness. The prison walls of false experience soon build themselves into barriers, shutting out the light, and the child grows into a woman or man, often losing their sense of that inner guide, leading their steps aright. We must return the way we came, as little children who know that life is good and to be trusted. We are to approach our problems as though they were not. Approaching them in this manner, they will vanish. Let not the materialist deny us this right, nor the unbelieving cast any reflections of his blindness before our eyes. There is wisdom and power, not of the flesh, which springs perennially from the inner life, all powerful and all wise. Matthew 18, verse 3.
Thus saith the Lord. Words of wisdom. Well, a few weeks ago, I needed a song, so God handed me one.
I don't know what to say about it, except it's pretty good. It's called Nothing But God. In the beginning was nothing but God. God was the only thing. The Word was God, and the Word was with God, beyond understanding. Then the Word was spoken, matter came into form, the universe was made, and the Word was made flesh, and human beings were born. That's what Spirit said. It was a miracle. Wasn't that a miracle? Now down the road, there's still nothing but God. God is the only thing. And I walk that road as I'm walking with God. Understanding my world has power to shape into form. Oh, that's how life is made. My faith is feeling more colorful and warm, and I am unafraid. I am a miracle. Am I not a miracle? If all God makes is miraculous, and we are made of Spirit, then we are one with the Absolute. You can't refute the Word when you hear it. Wake up every morning, God, it is the life we lead, and everything we see is nothing but God. As we are planting seeds, our words are spoken, our love is given fully and freely. Our purpose is seeing, oh, that Spirit within. In everybody, oh yes, we are miracles. Oh, aren't we all miracles? Yes, we are miracles. Aren't we all miracles? Yes, we are miracles. Aren't we all miracles?
Okay, we're in the flow. So Amandara and I are whispering about what's going to come next. That is that she is going to be up here and explain to us what is going on. So it's so fun to have her back in our midst. I know that we've all enjoyed having her speak more often, and I certainly have. So please help me welcome Reverend Dr. Amandara McClendon.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Happy Palm Sunday. So today, and welcome to our visitors. Today I am going to be speaking about being self-conscious in an unconscious world. It's Palm Sunday, And if you're like me, you grew up inside of the Christian church, where around this time of the year, we recognize the master teacher, Jesus. And that Sunday when he was riding into the holy city, and thousands were going into the holy city for Passover, for that whole Jewish celebration. And they laid palms down, and they laid their coats down as Jesus rode into the city, because they were just so excited. They've been hearing about this master teacher, this man doing miracles, and some of them had actually been in his presence. Others had just heard, others had experienced him, and they were excited. They were excited because they just knew they had someone that was going to liberate them. They had a king, someone who was gonna show up and have them move outside of that space they were in, which was under Roman rule. Jesus accepted their respect, their tributes. He did not accept that role that they were trying to give him. He did not come to them to be their king and release them from a physical bondage. He had come to release them from a consciousness prison. Jesus was self-conscious, meaning he knew who he was. Now, this is really interesting. Did you realize that there are two definitions of self-conscious? So the self-conscious that we are usually familiar with has to do with feeling embarrassed or afraid of the attention from others. How many of you said, heard people say, I'm self-conscious, I don't want to do that? And many of us have been self-conscious. That's one of the definitions. The biggest fear that we have is not of death. It's public speaking. Because we're just terrified that somebody's going to say something about the way we look, how we sound, what we say. That space of anxiety that brings embarrassment, ill at ease, embarrassment, fear, all of that. And our society feeds that. Our society helps us to be self-conscious. Right now, I have no idea why. Every other commercial is about Botox. Botox! You know, these beautiful people sitting down, well, you know, I just had a couple of wrinkles here and I decided, you know, I was gonna go get Botox. Because I didn't want those wrinkles. So now we're all self-conscious of wrinkles in our face. Like, oh my God, somebody's saying hi, and they're like, oh, they're looking at that, those lines on my head. It feeds our self-consciousness in that definition. That's a definition. I had someone ask me one Sunday about me speaking. It's like, do you get afraid, you know, before you get up to speak? I have spoken to large crowds. And I smiled, I said, no, because it's not about me. When I speak, it's not about me. It's about everyone I'm speaking to. I'm excited because I am bringing messages. And I know someone sitting in the audience is going to benefit from the message that I'm bringing. So no, I'm not afraid because it's not about me. And that is a place moving out of the definition of self-consciousness that we're familiar with into another definition. This is the second definition. Self-conscious is aware of one's existence, conscious of one's own being, your true essence. That's the second self-conscious. That's the definition that Jesus stood inside of when I say Jesus was self-conscious. Jesus was self-conscious and stepped into an unconscious world because all of the people in the world were not conscious to who they were. They had a different consciousness, that first definition of consciousness. Jesus was a master teacher, and I just loved the way he taught. He taught through parables, and the parables had to do with what was going on in that day and time. And he also taught by demonstration. He gave demonstrations. One of the commercials I love that's been showing here lately during the season has to do with the washing of feet. You see the commercial and all these different people washing the feet. That's what Jesus did. He demonstrated that I'm no bigger than you are. I can wash your feet. And so today, I want to take an example from Jesus and do a demonstration. Someone asked me earlier, was I going to turn this water into wine? I said, no, I am not doing that demonstration. So the reading this morning had to do with little children. This vase represents who we are, our essence, our purity, because that's who we are. We're pure beings. We're divine beings, and that's what this vase represents. And little children show up a certain way. Now, I need you to help me with this demonstration. I need you to shout out to me some of the ways little children show up in the world. And I'm talking about the positive ways they show up in the world. So I'll start off and say, they're always excited.
Yeah. Curious.
Curious.
Loving.
Enthusiastic. Enthusiastic.
Innocent.
Playful.
Playful.
Full of energy.
Full of energy.
Innocent.
Happy.
Happy. What's up with this side of the room over here? Come on, give me some more.
Tricksters.
What?
Tricksters,
gregarious.
Joyful. Curious.
Curious.
Fun loving.
Forgiving.
Yes.
Forgiving.
Energetic.
Mm-hmm. Non-judgmental.
Oh, yes.
Okay, you go on the playground, they don't say, well, what kind of shoes you got on? I don't think I'm gonna play with you. What kind of day is like, can you push me on this swing? Can you play with me?
Right.
Okay, what else? Give me a couple more.
Hungry.
Eager.
Patient.
Accepting.
Accepting.
Questioning.
Curious.
Curious. So this, that's our pure essence. That's who we are when we show up on this planet. Little children exhibit that essence. There's no doubting. They have no names about who someone is. They just stand in this pure space. Now remember when the reading talked about they hadn't been coming over yet, they hadn't been called sinners. Well, that came directly out of the Bible, but they hadn't been called anything negative. So I want to show you what happened. This is the self-consciousness that Jesus had. This is the self-consciousness that we're born with. That definition I gave you, the second definition. So where did that first definition come from? I want you now to help me out. I want you to give me some other adjectives, but this time I want you to give me adjectives that you heard that started covering up your pure essence. What are some of those things? Let's talk about the ones you could have heard from your home, from your family, you could have heard from society, you could have told yourself. What are some of those things?
Fear.
Fear.
Big.
Bad.
Not good enough.
Bad.
Sinner.
Not good enough. Sinner.
Not enough.
Not enough.
Criticism.
Mm.
Anger.
Stupid.
I'm stupid.
Yes.
Ugly.
Fearful.
I'm fearful.
Lazy.
Not smart.
Mm. Too loud.
Oh, yeah, too loud.
To this, to that, to this other.
Talk too much.
Oh, that's me.
And you're just not who you should be. Mm. What happens to our true essence?
It's cloudy.
It's covered. It's blocked.
Yeah.
Did it go away?
No.
It's still there. But just think, if you have years and years and years and years and years of that, you forget this is even here. You no longer feel it. So your self-consciousness becomes that first definition, this. So what happens that we can have an unconscious world? Well, if everybody is running around like this and they're not conscious, what kind of world do we have? An unconscious world. So the Dalai Lama gives us amazing definitions. He calls it the paradox of our age. This is directly from the Dalai Lama. The Dalai Lama says, we live in bigger houses, but smaller families. We have more conveniences, but less time. We have more degrees, but less sense. More knowledge, but less judgment. More experts, but more problems. More medicines, but less healthiness. Now I wanna tell you something about that. More medicines, but less healthiness. I got a call the other day from Kaiser Hospital, and she said, I'm the nurse practitioner and I'm calling because your doctor has ordered that you take Lipitor, and she wants you to take Lipitor and then come in 3 months and have your blood taken. And I said, okay, I hung up. And I said, Lipitor? I don't have high cholesterol. I don't have high blood pressure. I don't have diabetes. I don't have any of that. So I got online, looked up Lipitor, and Lipitor is for high cholesterol or people who have plaque in their arteries. And it has caused diabetes in some people. The manufacturers of Lipitor were actually sued, and the FDA took it off the market, and then they put it back on the market. I did some more research and found out it is the most prescribed medication in the United States right now. So I sent my doctor a message, we need to talk. Okay. She called me on Friday. The first thing my doctor said was, I didn't order this for you. I have no idea why they called you to tell you, don't you take that drug. I'm taking it out of your chart. And I said, well, because I can see my numbers because the way Kaiser is. Everything was fine. She said, I apologize because I have no idea why you got this call. So I called a nurse practitioner back. And I said, okay, so my doctor just told me she didn't order this. So who ordered it? And she said, well, you know, if you have high blood pressure, I said, I don't have any of that. She said, well, you know, I'm on a call with another client right now. I can't talk to you. I'll call you back. I have not got that call yet. But I will be calling her back again tomorrow. More medicines, less healthiness. What I believe happened, because I looked up where she came from, she comes from, they call hypertension prevention. I'm a certain age, I'm a female, I'm African American, you need to take this drug. Doesn't matter that your body's saying you don't need it, we say you need it. Less healthiness. Let me continue. We've been all the way to the moon and back, but have trouble crossing the street to meet the new neighbor. We build more computers to hold more information, to produce more copies than ever, but have less communication.
Yes.
There's a whole generation of individuals who do not answer the phone. You have to text them, and they will answer your text. And I just have to laugh. If you're sitting there and you answer my text, that means your phone did ring. You know I'm trying to get in touch with you. But that's the way they communicate. That's just the way they communicate. We have been long on quantity and short on quality. There are times of fast food, but slow digestion. There's so many commercials on TV about, oh, I got heartburn and I need to go take this. Why do you have heartburn? Don't take that. Get rid of the heartburn and stop eating that. Makes more sense to me. Tall men, but short of character. Steep profits, but shallow relationships. It's a time when there is much in the window, but nothing in the room. Much in the window and nothing in the room. I like to say we live in a time where people have Facebook lives. Mm-hmm. Facebook lives. Meaning that they want to feel good. This glitter represents trying to make this yuck feel good. So they pour on, oh, I'm doing happy, I'm doing fine. They send out all these pictures of them having fun, doing all this great stuff, going on vacations. And it's all window dressing. And they keep doing it, and they do more, and they do more. And then we start seeing dribbles of it coming down to us. We start believing it. There are so many individuals who go on Facebook and they believe what they're seeing. And it's not true. It's window dressing. And they just keep doing the window dressing more and more and more and more and more. And they begin to believe it themselves. What's happening? All of the window dressing is just getting all in the gook. Is it reaching the true essence? It never will. It never will. Because it is not real. It's false. So we are living in a world where people are not conscious to who they are, but they're desperately, desperately trying to get here. But they don't realize that that's what they're doing. And so as a result, they keep doing this. And they believe, and even look at that. Even when it goes down, it comes right back up. It comes right back up. So how do we return to living in a true state of self-consciousness, not that false state? What do we have to do? Tell me, what do you think we have to do? If this is our true essence, and we want more of that, what do you think we have to do?
Skim off the gunk.
How do you get rid of the gunk?
Skim off the top.
You can skim off the top, or you could
align with spirit.
Add more.
Add more.
Add more. So let me make sure. Yeah. We add more joy. Mm-hmm. Happiness.
Joyful.
Love. Communication.
Givingness.
Givingness.
Playfulness.
Playfulness.
Understanding.
Understanding.
Approval.
Approval.
Grateful.
Being grateful.
Prayer.
Prayer.
Acceptance.
Acceptance.
Uh-oh.
Forgiveness.
Uh-oh.
Care, love, peace, harmony. Look what happened.
Joy.
Joy, joy.
We reach who we are.
Yay.
So ways to uncover your true essence. Spend time with yourself.
Meditation.
Five things. Oh, I have to share this with you. I wrote this book. It's not a book. It's a journal. I created it when I wrote my book. It's called the Appreciation Journal. Every morning, write down five things you appreciate about yourself. Every morning I do this. Because what happens is that this is what happens. Every morning I'm saying, I love the fact that I'm a good friend. I love the fact that I do this. I love the fact that I show up. So every morning I'm pouring more of my true essence in. And even though society is trying to do this, I do this. And when I pour more essence in, I can keep that from keeping me covered over. Share your unique gifts with the world. Look at this. This is a talent. Mm. This individual here has talent. And she's sharing it with us all the time. She takes what's just God's gift to her and puts it into this beautiful bouquet and brings it to us so that we can share in her pure gift. So you share your gifts with the world. Enroll in the class. I think we have one coming up soon. Enroll in the class. Start learning more of how you can keep this in place. Clean out your spaces in your house, in your garage, in the closets, in the drawers.
How about your telephone?
Yeah. Because it allows space. It allows energy to move through space. I was speaking to someone yesterday. I've been working with her almost a year on purging out her house. And she's doing it. And it's taking time, but she's working towards it. Identify unique ways to stay self-conscious every day. You come up with whatever works for you. Just create it. I like to walk on the beach. I'm so blessed that I don't live that close to the ocean. People come from thousands of miles all over the world to come to our backyard. I am so happy that when I go down there, I'm walking around in my backyard. I have the ocean there. Jesus was self-conscious by understanding his divinity. We have to continue to stay self-conscious by living as little children, being more playful, more forgiving. Don't doubt, just trust. Understand that God is good and we are good, no matter what someone else says. The self-consciousness, begin to let it go, release it. It has nothing to do with me. It has to do with someone else trying to pour. When you don't feel well emotionally, realize that self-consciousness allows you to step back and look at your emotions. When you can look at your emotions and you can look at your thoughts and then you can decide what behavior you want to do, you are self-conscious, the way Jesus was self-conscious. Thoughts come to us all the time. They come directly out of what we call race consciousness. And right now, we have so much swirling around our society, just all kinds of chaos and emotions. A lot of times, the thoughts that run through your head aren't yours. We're like radios. We pick up things. So if you pick up things, if you're self-conscious, you can say, oh, wait a minute, that's not mine. And you can let it go. You can identify. So when you're able to step back and watch yourself, and understand that somebody else may be totally upset at you. That may have nothing to do with you. That has all to do with them. But unless you can separate it, it's going to cause you to be upset. And it's going to cause you to go into that other self-conscious place. Oh, I did something wrong. I shouldn't have done that. And it has nothing to do with you. We're human. That's going to happen. But when you can step back and separate out from that, you know you are living as a self-conscious being. So I want to conclude with this reading from Science of Mind and a quote from Ernest Holmes. Science of Mind reading. I take the time for introspection to increase my awareness of hidden and limiting beliefs so that I can change them to expanding beliefs that propel me forward on my spiritual journey. Ernest Holmes quotes, he says, an inner light shines forth and frees me from the bonds of the false belief. This is always shining forth and will free us from whatever false belief that comes flying by us. This is how we stay and live as self-conscious human beings. I want to add a blessing to these words and a blessing to each and every one of you this morning. Thank you.
Wow. I like that second definition better. So here's a song that I wrote about a month ago or so. It's really a song from God.
Let us now prepare for standing in that place of self-consciousness as we lovingly give to our center, understanding and knowing that the power within each and every one of us is the gift to give. As we give, we receive. And I'm knowing right here, right now, that each and every one of us are blessed, and we give that blessing into the universe, knowing it will come back to us fuller than we could ever dream of. And I say thank you for our blessing, and so it is.
I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed.
And Reverend Maddie is going to do our closing for us.
God is love. God is light. God's love and light are ever shining. It is shining through each one of us this morning. And as we prepare to leave, I recognize that each of us is that light. Each of us is that true essence of love. That is our true selves. That is who I am. That is who you are. And we know that this light, this love, brightens the world wherever we go. And we remember this truth. So as we move into our respective worlds during this Easter celebration, we remember this truth. We let our lights shine. We let our true lights reflect the essence of love, the essence of being, and we give thanks. And on this note, I ask you to affirm this truth with me by saying, and so it is.
Open your heart, let your love go free. Out over the ocean, right across the stream. Let it flow like a river, let it fly like a dove. Till your heart remembers, you can't stop love. Once you get it started, watch what it does. It'll go full circle. You can't stop love. Open your heart, let your love go free. Out over the ocean, right across the stream. Let it flow like a river. Let it fly like a dove. Your heart remembers, you can't stop love. Once you get it started, watch what it does. It'll go full circle. You You can't stop love.